My name's Chidera, popularly known online as the Slum Flower, and I'm an award-winning blogger slash twice published author. And my relationship with Peckham is that I've lived here pretty much my whole life. So that's 23 years of being an original Peckham gal.
Basically, my friend Will gave me the name, and I don't know, there's something about it that really excited me.
What I like about the Peckham community is we're all very supportive of each other.
Because although I am not the little sister, although my middle sister thinks she's the oldest, I am the oldest sister. So in honour of my two sisters, I created Little Sister.
The Peckham itself is full of a lot of history, and there's so much diversity that you can walk down the street and get food from almost every country there is.
What I like the most about Peckham is how accessible everything is. So I can go down the road and get a wig, go down the road and get argan oil, go down the road and get milk, go down the road and see aunties who look like me.
The auntie shouting at auntie, you're gonna wanna do your hair? And I'm like, no thank you, I don't have any hair, you know, but still.
I don't know, everybody that says the name smiles, and that's what I want. You know? Yeah, that's exactly what I want.
African food, Indian food, Chinese food, American food, British food, everything's here.
The Peckham Flex. Yeah, I've seated down in there many a times. I remember when the tickets were $2.99. Like, I'm an original OG.
So it's really nice to be in an environment where everything that attaches to my identity is within reach. But most of all, what I love about Peckham is the fact that there are so many black people here. I love being around black people. I think it's so important as a black person to be around people who look like you, feel like you. They don't necessarily have to think like you, but it's just nice to see people who represent you.
And it can feel that way, but it can also be intimidating to a lot of people who have never been here before. You know, all they hear is stories. Oh God, don't go to Peckham, you're gonna get stabbed. Come on, man.
You know, like everyone has that kind of stigma. Oh, Peckham's rough, oh, Peckham's this, oh, Peckham's that. And I thought, you know what?
So I've always wanted to be Peckham's very own. Like, I always wanted to be someone that people would feel very proud to refer to as, she's from Peckham. Like, did you know she's from Peckham?
I felt like there was people here that I could relate to. I could see people similar like myself.
Because I do feel like London does birth a lot of heroes, icons, and prestigious people. I feel like Peckham needs someone like me. And so I wanted to be that person that Peckham needs, because there were so many negative connotations attached to Peckham growing up.
You can see that everybody just wants to make it something better. And from what I understand, Peckham is becoming something it wasn't. So it's becoming better, but it's also got its faults.
And Peckham's changed quite a lot, mostly in the last 3 years, but it's grown organically. So it's been young upstarts, it's been businesses that are sort of wanting, young people wanting to start a business.
I think that the challenges for me is really gentrification. That's the thing we do not speak about. We will not name it, but our hearts will go boom, 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 boom.
I remember being, you know, 15, 16, when people would ask me what area I'm from, I'd tell them I'm from Peckham, and they'll be like, have you got a gun on you yet? Like, and I always used to be confused and think, why do they think I'm strapped up? But then I remembered that Peckham has had a lot of issues with crime, which is, you know, reducing as of the recent 5 years due to Peckham changing a lot. Basically, lots of white people are moving into Peckham, so the face of Peckham is definitely shifting.
And Peckham, everybody's flocking to Peckham, so Peckham's a place to be. And from what I understand, Peckham went from nobody wanting to live here to everybody wanting to live here.
What we're having is this circular thing where it's more than a slow creep. It's speeding up. I think in the last 4 or 5 years, we're seeing, you know, a lot of our local businesses, our African businesses disappearing, a lot of the meat. I mean, I know not everybody liked the meat shops, but a lot of the meat shops going.
Peckham has a lot of culture, a lot of seasoning, a lot of texture, but what we don't realise about people, about white people moving into spaces where there's a lot of culture, is that that culture has been created by people of colour, especially black people. So what they do is they move into these places that have been seasoned up by black people, then move the black people out, and then live off the remains of black people, as in the cultural remains of black people, and that always rubs me the wrong way.
The other thing that comes with gentrification is Lots of people want to live here and enjoy living here, and obviously the house prices go up, but with that is a knock-on effect that it marginalises people and it pushes people out of the area that have lived here for decades, and they no longer can afford the rent, so they're having to go somewhere else, and I think that's unfortunate.
That for me is really irritating, because there was a time when no one wanted to live here and now everyone wants to be here because it's cool, urban, all the cool people, aka black people, are from all these urbanised areas that people are moving into.
You know, we've done what we do to promote Peckham as a thing, as a destination, as an exciting, interesting place. And I'd like to see, local government giving us something back and helping to support our endeavours.
The other side of all this is that people are losing the spaces that they've created to make money. So there's a bunch of hairdressers that are going to be shut down and knocked down, and then new buildings are going to be built, and those hairdressers are going to be moved to a different street that's further away from the main street, which means they're going to get less business, which will make it harder for them to look after their kids. Their kids and those hairdressers are part of what adds cultural value to Peckham. So it's not fair to reduce the quality of life of those people whose environment you're coming to enjoy.
Because I'm originally from West London, we used to make a mecca to Peckham. We come, we buy our spices, buy our food, buy our hair, and then, you know, and go back to Paddington, because we just don't have that there. So there's a big people don't really realise there is a big influx of people coming from all up the black diaspora coming to Peckham to get what they need, because their areas have become gentrified and they can't find it.
A part of me does believe these changes are good for Peckham, because Peckham is relatively safer. There are more job opportunities. However, I still feel like those job opportunities aren't going to the people who live here.
I'm that kind of person. I can go anywhere where white people are, Indian people, Chinese, and walk in there by myself and don't feel away. But for somebody else who doesn't have that, you know, that feeling that they can just go somewhere and just belong, even if it's by themselves, I feel that it's down to, not just down to them, but in a way it is down to them to kind of make people feel a lot more welcome, especially the people from the community.
People can go anywhere, they can get on the overground and go to East London if they want vintage. But you know, people are hunting me out and they're finding me. And why is that? And I think that's because they want you, in a way.
I think independent businesses are important to the local community and other communities, because people want to have a connection with the business owners and the staff that work there. They want to feel that they're buying something local, they're buying into a whole sort of ethos.
Because Peckham's in desperate need of more boutiques that are going to favour white people. And why I'm making this clear distinction between black and white people is because white people will always benefit off being white, no matter what environment or circumstance they're in, but black people don't get to benefit from being black. And that's just the pure reality of things.
I'd just like things to stop now, at this stage. I don't want it to move on. I don't want it to become Brixton. I've got a lot of people coming through from Brixton saying how that it's not for them. It's become lots of local businesses have been pushed out, you know, and that could very well happen here.
Because it's reaching that point now. There was a time when no one wanted to live in Notting Hill because it was full of black people.
You know, having a, you know, kind of a homogeneous, samey high street like everywhere else. We're not like everywhere else, we're Peckham.
I'm always constantly taking in everything and being like, who knows what's going to get knocked down next.
But if we become like a Notting Hill or wherever, then what about working class people or whatever their colour or race or religion? Where are they going to go to shop? We can't all go shopping in Marks and Spencers or Waitrose. We can't afford it.
I think, you know, it would be damaging, I think, for a lot of small businesses to have a Costa or Starbucks more come in, because they serve food and they serve processed food and stuff like that. Although it's expensive, it's convenient for people, so they'll get it. So there goes not only a coffee shop, but maybe a small deli.
I shop locally. You know, I buy the majority of my things on this high street. You know, but if you do not shop locally, if you do not support us, we will die. We will not continue to grow. We will not be here. All you have was these Topshop, you know, Marks and Spencer's, WH Smith's, or, you know, Sports Direct, all of those stuff. And it would be just another boring high street. And you know, you could get off your bus with a little blindfold and the dump you here and you could be, where could you be? You could be in Milton Keynes, you could be in anywhere. But you know, right now, Peckham is exciting, it's vibrant, it's full of so many different creative people, so many interesting people, so many local people who've born and brought up here. And at this point, I think it's really cool and I really love it. But yeah, I'm a little bit uncertain about the future because gentrification has its pluses, but it also definitely has its negatives. It doesn't take everybody with it. And I think, you know, we need a diverse community, we really do, and a diverse retail community. All our communities need to be served.